Hey, sub furies. So after the number of times that I've been asked, or I've seen other people ask this particular question about Avatar The Last Airbender, I decided to make a video on it to give a clear and concise answer. What is the true origin of bending the elements of air, water, earth, and fire? Because Aang and Korra seem to disagree on a few things. Let's get started. In Avatar The Last Airbender, the show makes pretty clear that a long time ago, benders learned to bend their elements from the natural masters of those elements. After all, Princess Yue explained, water benders saw the moon push and pull the tides, and learned to do it themselves. In fact, mimicking the tides is the very first waterbending move that Aang learns from Katara. Then in the episode, The Cave of Two Lovers, we learn about Omar and Shu, the supposed first earthbenders, who learned from Badger Moles how to bend the element of earth. Of course, the Sun Warriors make pretty clear that dragons were the original firebenders, and of course, the Sky Bison are repeatedly stated to be the original airbenders. Seems simple enough, right? But things are complicated in season 2 of Legend of Korra, when we learn about Avatar 1, the first Avatar. We learn that a long time ago, before the era of the Avatar, humans lived on cities on the backs of lion turtles, who would bestow on them the power of an element when they went out into the wild to protect themselves. Depending on which city they were in, they'd either be given water, earth, fire, or air. Then when they returned to the city from the wild, the lion turtle would take back the element from the bender. So we know for sure,
and we can theorize about other ones,
that there was an air lion turtle, an earth lion turtle, a water lion turtle, and a fire lion turtle. But which origin story is it? Did we learn to get the elements from the badger moles and dragons and sky bison and the moon? Or did we get it from the lion turtles? Well, the answer is simple, really. One may have gotten the ability to bend the elements from the lion turtles, but he had to learn how to bend it from the original benders. In this careful shot here, we see Wan doing the dancing dragon, one of the oldest learning firebending techniques, alongside a white dragon. This is unlike any of the other humans we see using fire, who don't really have any real technique. In other words, they're not bending it. Bending is more complex than just having the ability to use fire. It's more of an art. Imagine being given a sword, but not being taught how to use it. You can swing it around, but you're not very good at it, as my partner repeatedly informs me. This does raise a few difficult questions though, like if Omar and Shu were the first earthbenders, then how does this fit with the Lion Turtle's story? The likelihood that the story of Omar and Shu learning from badger moles underground is probably just a myth. It's been way blown out of proportion. Like, there might have been two earthbenders who were in love and met underground in these caves, but they probably weren't the first earthbenders. It really just makes for a good founding story of the city of Omashu. But that isn't the only question. Given any of the humans that left the city in Avatar 1's story could receive the element of fire, and assumedly any of the other elements, does this mean that every human in the Avatar world has the ability to bend, but just hasn't had it unlocked yet? How much of bending is genetic, given that Wan was technically able to handle more than one element? When asking for the element of air, the lion turtle replied, "No human has ever bent two elements before," but he clearly believes it is possible. The lion turtle really just instructed Rava to hold the element for Wan as a kind of mentor. A caution, like, you're not allowed to play with air, Spyro, until you've learned to be responsible for it. Though to be fair, the air element was actually Cinder's power anyway. And on top of that, like, how does energy bending even really work? All these questions, though, we'll have to wait for another video. Though I'm like really excited to talk about what the hell chi means in the Avatar universe. It's really complex and it's awesome. But that's all from me, sub furies. My question for you is, what element would you bend and why? Tell me down in the comments below. I'm coming up on 10,000 subscribers really soon, guys. Like, oh wow, thank you. And I wanted to squeeze in another video before I started working on that Q&A. By the way, keep the questions coming on the comments and in Twitter and on Facebook. I love hearing what you have to ask me. I really just wanted to make this video because it's one of the most common questions that I tend to get asked or see other people asking. And if you have any other specific questions about Avatar, then please let me know, because I love doing these videos. Anyways, thanks for watching, sub furies. I'll see you in the future.